we're gonna cover the new suspension geometry that we have on the 2.0 SCT truck. First, we started off by kind of identifying what we wanted the 2.0 SCT to do improved over the original. And the key was to make it just like the 2.0 buggy, just easier to drive for everybody, whether you're the pro racer or Joe Club racer, but without losing the speed that the 22 chassis has. So testing the 22 2.0 front end geometry with the different offset caster blocks and spindles, that was something we also found advantageous on the 2.0 short course. So we have included the 2.0 buggy caster blocks along with the new spindle that has less offset for the bell crank system. The steering bell crank system allows for smoother steering off center when you first get into the wheel, but then as you get farther into the wheel, you have less Ackerman angle, which keeps the two tires more parallel and gives you an outer angle increase on your outer tire, which helps low speed steering. So the good changes all the way around. Easier to drive high speed and right off center entering the sweepers, but more steering in those really slow low speed 180s. Also for the 22SCT 2.0, we've added longer front arms and rear arms to widen the track width front and rear. What this does is it really gives a nice stable wide platform for the 22SCT 2.0 to be even more stable than the original truck. Originally, the 22SCT was on the narrower end of the scale, but now we're just inside of maximum legal width to give you the most stable platform possible. Also in the rear end, we've added an all-new rear suspension hub, which has less offset from the center of the wheel to the outer rear hinge pin. This allows the rear of the truck to get into the set just like the original, but to also not get held down in that set and return ride height a lot easier. This gives the truck a lot more consistent and stable feel around the track. It also helps it change directions a lot quicker without getting upset. A higher rear hub, taller, also allows us to get more camber gain in the rear of the vehicle so that when the truck leans over, that outer tire still keeps a good contact patch with the ground. For the 22SCT 2.0, we found that we liked more droop during our extensive testing, and by more droop, just more down travel. So when the suspension sagging, you can see how much more clearance you have off the table than the original model. What this does is it just lets the truck roll a little bit more, but roll comfortably. When you don't have enough droop, the truck tries to roll, but as soon as the suspension kind of bottoms out, it almost acts like a bump stop in the reverse direction. So with this extra droop, you get a more consistent and manageable roll in each of the turns around the track. You also get better landing for large jumps, so the jumping and landing on the 2.0 is also improved. We also added the CVA offset change that we've really liked on the 22 2.0 buggy by moving the axle 1 millimeter further into the hub. On the short course, it's not adjustable, it's just a preset setting where the axle is 1 millimeter further into the hub. So we do have a new rear axle for the 22SCT 2.0. We've really done a lot of work on the suspension geometry, and we've done more than just an update here or there. With an all new front arm, rear arm, hub, caster box, spindle, steering rack, and shock lengths front and rear, the suspension geometry of the 22 2.0 is very much optimized and improved. Just all those little trick options that we've learned on the 2.0 vehicles, we think you'll find it a lot easier to drive and get you into a victory circle even more often.